Etude number 30 by Weisenborn has a much more lively character than number 21. So we are going to look for spunky, energetic staccato notes and a driving energy through the lyricism of the slurred notes in between. There are, in a sense, two voices in this etude. The staccato notes bring out one line. Staccato notes are a string bass plucking a pizzicato, and slurred notes are a cello playing with the bow. Etc. So it's important to let your listener hear that these two ideas are going on, and yet not separate them so much that they don't connect into four bar phrases. So with the staccato, I'm thinking of lots of energy in my airstream. A common mistake is that we use too much tongue in staccato. The tongue is still going to be very light as it touches the reed and just defines the beginning of the note. It's the air that gives it the sudden energy and clarity. To not put too much surface area of the tongue or to whack the reed too hard with your tongue there. What else to talk about? In measures 5 to 9, for instance, this upper voice is all that C to B to back to C happens 8 times, which can be really monotonous and obnoxious. So we want to lighten that up so it doesn't get too, drive us too crazy. You don't want to bring it out too much or it really gets obnoxious. I will demonstrate being obnoxious. It's a little too driving and heavy there. So I'm aiming for a different dynamic on the staccato notes than the lyrical notes up above. And notice my slurred notes did get a little more intense toward the end of the phrase to help the overall line intensify, but I kept them really soft at the beginning. So, have fun with this one.